Philly Pothead.
Transformation to unlock the transformation control. You have to attend that class.
Inventory. Turn this stupid thing in. My father delighted to hear that you and I had spent the afternoon and get this the Saturday truth. I've got laugh at that first. Da, 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 da. Did he read this yet, babe? Oh my God. I'm reading it in my head. I'm not gonna read this shit out loud. It's too much. It's ridiculous. Okay. It's all pointless nonsense. You learned the spell, huh? You think you're all that, you monster? Learning one of the forgettables? Unforgivables?
I'll say it again. Can't thank you enough for helping to save the village from those
two. Hello, Serena. I have good news. I was able to provide my friends with a box to call her with a little potion, and I found a box of letters.
Oh, thank you.
Were you just doing that one?
I wondered about some of the letters in the box. Of course. It appears most of the letters were from fellow
students. One of the letters mentioned credit practice. Did you play?
I did. Was the Ravenclaw seeker down by 140 points? I'll never forgive Professor Black for cancelling it this year. I missed cheering for Ravenclaw.
I saw a letter from someone named Mirabelle. Is that Professor Black?
It is. Still one of my dearest friends. I know she wouldn't mind having seen that letter. She and I are of a similar mind. Especially when it comes to young people. We believe experience to be an invaluable teacher. To borrow a phrase from Mirabelle, it's a joy to see anyone blossom, but particularly one who doubted they ever would.
I spotted a letter from you to Mrs. Spottle. You two seem to have a lot of fun together.
We do. She taught me so much during my summers with her. I shall be the first to admit that adolescents aren't always the easiest to understand. But the depth of their kindness and that of so many of my friends got me through some challenging times, to put it mildly.
I'm glad I could be of help. Mrs. Spottle sends her best.
Don't know what I'd have done without her, Aidan. thank you again for helping her. And for returning this box of letters. It's nice to reflect on good memories.
And you got a hippogriff. How dare you. So I'm doing that one main quest.
This is a strange journal. I should have hesitated.
Thank you.
Did you find her father?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, well, what's he? That's helpful. I don't think he did his quest.
Thank you for making me a prisoner's object.
I think I found out where he is.
Oh, you're trying to get up there?
I was already up there. What's Patango?
Patango is the one where you go push the triangle.
No.
Oh.
I don't know
the looks of
that encampment.
Ah, you dumb fuck. I do plenty of defeats.
Oh, I didn't know. You do the defeats.
You get items for them, so why would I do it?
It's called
Tuesday.
Tuesday for sure. Gotta go up. Wake me up at 1 so I can go out there.
Yeah.
You damn heavy! God, you see that?
I'm sorry.
They only shoot unblockable ability, so how am I supposed to? Oh well.
Okay.
Let's get up there. Found him, babe. Babe, I found him. I'm gonna go rescue him, babe.
Sweetie, no, of course not.
Babe, send that off. I can do that to you. I can't hear.
You did it!
Found my wand!
Wait!
You're a student?
Oh, we must get you to safety immediately. It's dangerous!
It's all right, Mr. Oaks. I've dealt with these goblins before.
Dear Merlin, you're either very lucky or very talented. How did you find me?
I'm a friend of Adelaide's. She was worried about your business with Van Rock's lawyers.
Oh, she was right to be. I couldn't go through with the agreement, and when I told them, I ended up blindfolded and behind bars. Been locked in that infernal cell for so long, I forgot I was even there. I overheard things. If only I could reward you for what you've done. Blasting goblins stole every canut on me. All I can say is thank you. Truly.
You mentioned you overheard things.
Sad tale, really. I think I know where Ramrock's unfortunate vendetta against wizardkind began. Although dragon breeding was outlawed by the Warlocks Convention of 1709, Ranrock stumbled upon an illegal dragon camp. He was young, found the creatures fascinating. He'd visit the camp in secret whenever he could, never making his presence known. After weeks of sly surveillance, he finally summoned the courage to speak to the wizard in charge. Ranrock wanted to join them and the creatures. The wizard happened to drop his wand. Ranrock saw an opportunity. He picked it up and to hand it back as a means of introducing himself. The size of a goblin with a wand sent the wizard into an instant rage. He beat Ranrock nearly to death. Ever since, Ranrock has despised wizardkind. Sees us all as cruel.
Am I right you speak gobbledygook?
Unbeknownst to Ranrock's fiends, I do. I've always had an affinity for goblin culture. Knew I wanted to be a metal trader ever since I was a lad. It wasn't easy learning the language. It's complex. My memory's as weak as my knees these days. But after decades working with fine goblin folk, I grew fairly proficient. At least, I'd like to think so.
I'm grateful I was able to help you, Mr. Oaks.
Why Oaks doesn't like humans?
Only I have resorted to trading with such fiends. A lesson I shan't soon forget.
When the whisper is like being reunited with an old friend.
I must return home and inform Adelaide of my safety. Will you be alright?
You're a house elf.
You get back to Adelaide. I assure you her worries outweigh yours.
Oh, I'm anxious to see my dear niece. And then I plan to travel far from here for my next round of trading.
I watch you play, and you don't watch me play.
Justly for your deeds.
You were sweet.
Be well, my friend.
Oh, I'm sorry, ugly face.
Mr. Oaks was lucky.
Ranrock never afraid him. You know.
Rebellion.
Do you let me know if I can be of any assistance at all?
See you again.
Farewell for now.
Come here, Bambi. Babe, did you feed Bambi?
Yes. I told you I've got all the
Mysterious, and it's something.
like, and subscribe, like, watch my videos. I'd appreciate it. Peace out.